morning, ladies and gentlemen and boys of Lamanya College, Lucknow. Today is the 1st of October of the year 2021, and we mark the culmination of what we refer to as the Doddrant's bicentenary of this college. During the last year, we have commemorated 175 years from the time of the establishment of the college. As you can understand, this would have been a milestone for major celebration, which we have been looking forward to for years together. But the pandemic was a far more disastrous event, which absolutely cancelled all plans of celebration. We are grateful that at the end of the 175 years, we have come out of this unscathed. We have faced losses. We have lost dear ones. And we will always remember that the 175th year was marred with sorrow due to this. But in these 175 years, and the last year in particular, we have learned to adjust to new systems. We have been able to make adjustments in our philosophy. We have been able to see how our college is to adapt to these requirements and situations. And I am happy to note that despite a few problems, we have been able to come out of this looking forward to the next 25 years. This morning's program is a reprise of what we did last year. It's a lovely reminder that a year later, the spirit of Lamanya still stands strong. Even as we limp back to normalcy and look forward to carrying out and fulfilling all the traditions that have developed over 175 years, we still use this virtual mode to commemorate this day and to look forward with great positivity to the years ahead for Lamanya College. Vive Lamanya! The 1st of October, the year 2020. It is a privilege to be inside this magnificent monument called Constantia. Constantia is central to this institution of repute that today celebrates 175 years of the commencement of classes. A proud day for all of us, and for generations of Martinians who have taught, worked, and studied here. It took 45 years for the vision of the founder, Major General Claude Martin, to reach fruition in Lucknow. The Lucknow Martinier is the youngest of the Martiniers in Kolkata, Lyon, because it took 45 years for the will to be probated. It took 45 years for the highest people in the land to give their approval for every aspect of establishing the institution. The Nawab of Awadh, from whom permission was necessary to set up an institution that would also teach the Christian faith and the English language. The resident of Lucknow, the East India Company officials in Calcutta, the Supreme Court at Calcutta, going eventually to the Privy Council of the United Kingdom, which then directed the court in Kolkata to set out a decree for the establishment of the institution. This was completed on the 21st of December in the year 1840. It took some more time
understandably, for the infrastructure to be established, the north and south wing of Constantia to be set up for classrooms and other ancillary requirements. On the 13th of September, in the year 1845, it was decreed that the institution would be established. But on that day, all that could be done was to register the boys and then close for a break. The first principal of the college, John Newmarsh, could only come to Lucknow on the 23rd of September in 1845. Classes could therefore begin a week later, the 1st of October, 1845. Principal Newmarsh was met in Lucknow by the first honorary secretary of the college, Dr. James Spencer Logan, the surgeon to the resident of Lucknow. He is best known as being the guardian of Maharaja Dilip Singh, the son of the famous Ranjit Singh of the Kohinoor diamond fame. It was Logan who procured that Kohinoor diamond, looked after the young Maharaja, took him and the diamond to England, and ingratiated himself with Queen Victoria, where the diamond still remains part of the crown jewels. Dr. Logan is also credited with having established the first rules of the college, which are extant today, some of which are still followed unabridged. Newmarsh got down to business immediately. It was presumed that the institution would be able to house between 120 to 150 boys. It was divided into two schools, the native school and the Eurasian and European school. The areas were also clearly demarcated. The north wing housed the Eurasian and European boys, and the south wing was for the Hindu and Muslim boys, and there was a very, very strong divide between the two sections. The establishments were completely different. Food was different. Staff and teachers were different. Books were different. Teaching apparatus was not the same. And there must have been tremendous discrimination at that time. 175 years later, the school functions as a single entity. It invites children of all backgrounds, of all faiths, of all standing, a complete cross-section of Indian society. That is what Claude Martin must have looked forward to. That was indeed the vision of the founder. The college has come a long way in fulfilling the founder's wishes. After 175 years, we still celebrate the munificence and the vision of that man who came from a foreign land and who made India his home. We respect the trustees and governors of the college who have directed the policy of the college over all these years. We record and recognize the 16 principals in the 175 years who have been pioneers, as well as who have contributed so much to the evolution of an institution in a brand that is called La Martinia today. We recognize the ranks of teachers who have given their best in changing the lives of children, the workers nameless so many of them, who have helped maintain this huge estate. But above all, the pupils of La Martinière, who having attended this institution, which they call their home, have made their lives so very different. We also recall the old boys of the college, some of whom have returned to give of their best for the progress of the institution. Together, all of us celebrate the wonderful idea that is La Martinière. Vive La Martinière.